We're back with another episode of the Daily Grossi. 1 week until the Browns pick. We're almost on the clock.
They're on the clock, right? Counting down from 1 to 54. The longest anticipated draft in history is almost here.
Am I crazy to think that, Tony? It feels like this has been the longest process ever. I couldn't even imagine if the Browns had a first round pick.
I know. And it's not like it's been longer calendar days wise. Remember that one draft they had in May?
Yes.
This is just the normal buildup, but I think every day around the league and including the Browns, it's just so anticipated that by now we're ready to get into that draft room.
Yeah. And you're talking about, you know, around the Browns this week, Tony, a lot happened. We heard from a lot of people, they're back in the building. What was your main major takeaway from the week of everybody back in the building and hearing from Kevin and Andrew?
Well, I think the one takeaway I had was everybody is on the same page that they expect Deshaun Watson to be ready for the regular season, that the medical team and trainers are managing him to get to that goal. And that doesn't necessarily mean we'll see him playing preseason games. We don't know just yet, but they're taking a conservative approach with the goal of having him ready for that first game in September.
And yeah, makes total sense. All right, Tony, we're going to do some Fact or Fiction Friday, some Brown stuff, some overall NFL stuff. I know you pay attention to everything. So let's have some fun. First one, Fact or Fiction, Deshaun Watson will earn a second contract with the Cleveland Browns.
Right out of the chute, huh?
Oh yeah.
Listen, I'm going to say fiction only because I think we need to see more this year before you can make that, that projection to a second contract. I think that's the goal of the Browns and Deshaun and everyone, because if that happens, there'll be a lot of good times ahead. But right now, I'm going to say fiction because I'm probably a little more skeptical than most.
There we go. You're always honest, Tony. You're always honest. Fact or fiction? DTR will be on the active roster week one.
Boy, I think that's a fiction also. And
wow.
I just think that they signed Tyler Huntley for a reason that might be more obvious to them than it is to us. And we haven't heard much about DTR's rehab from a hip injury. We know he didn't have surgery. And to this point, we don't know if he's even able to participate in OTAs coming up in a couple weeks, 5 weeks. So I think Tyler Huntley was acquired for the reason to guard against DTR being slower back than they expected.
And do you think it's only that, Tony, or do you think it's a little bit of them? I mean, it's not much of an investment. I mean, I know Andrew loves his draft picks, but it's not like DTR was a major pick investment as well.
Yeah. Furthermore, even if DTR is healthy and able to play in preseason, I think there's a gap between him and Tyler Huntley, and people say, well, they can't expose him to the practice squad. I don't see why not. I who would take a chance on DTR after, you know, the body of work that he has and coming off a hip injury? So yeah, I think it'll be Watson, Jameis Winston, and who's to say Tyler Huntley won't end up on the practice squad to begin the year too? So my answer is fiction.
There we go. All right, Tony, we're just the three hard ones out the gate. This will be Nick Chubb's last year with the Browns.
Oh, I always answer hopefully with anything to do with Chubb. So I'm going to say fiction. Although okay. I came away from this week thinking that both sides believe there's a long road of recovery ahead for Chubb, and they're not expecting much this year. Now, I think when it comes to 2025, it depends what Nick looks like at the end of 2024. And we don't even know when he's going to get on the field yet. So, but I'm pro Chubb all the way, and I'll say fact.
You know what's interesting, Tony, is They're definitely giving him a lot of leeway with his recovery in that grade. But I think they just love having him around. Like, that's what you pick up, is they just love having Nick. From Jimmy Haslam talking about it, to Andrew, to Kevin, to Deshaun, everybody, they love seeing him in that locker room.
I agree. And I think he had a contribution to last season by just being around. And as long as Chubb wants to be around, I think it motivates him to rehab. Listen, this is a gruesome injury at a time in his career. And I think also the contract that they agreed on indicates they're not expecting much from Chubb this year. You know, $2.2 million. The incentives are highly unlikely to be reached. But I think Chubb agreed to it because his side knows what he's up against.
There we go. Similar, you know, Browns running back question. Fact or fiction, Jerome Ford will lead the Browns in rushing next season.
I think it's fact. I don't know if he'll have 1,000 yards. In fact, I doubt it. But I think that he's the lead back of the committee, you know, that's in place. And he had, over 800 yards last year?
And I think
we're going to see a different running game this year. But I would say it's fact. He'll be leading the team in yards.
Here we go, Tony. So you're going to be the first one to find out. But let's get fact or fiction. Kevin Stefanski calls plays for the Browns at any point during next season. That's the caveat there, Tony. I switched it up.
I'm going to say fiction because that caveat makes it a real long shot. But I think I'm of the opinion that it's going to be Dorsey. Yeah. And until I change my opinion, I'm going to answer fiction to your question.
Okay. What did you take away from did you hear Kevin on with Riz talk about play calling? It was kind of interesting, Tony. He really downplays it when he talks about it publicly.
Yeah, and he also said he honestly hasn't made a decision yet, and you know, it's we'll see later on as we get closer to the season. Zach, I'm not buying it. I mean, I've just got to believe that he and Dorsey talked about play calling in the job interview. I mean, if you're, why wouldn't that come up? Why wouldn't you say, okay, I called plays in Buffalo. I think I'm good at it. What's your, you know, intent here? And I think it was discussed. I also think that Kevin is doing a lot of assistance to get Dorsey and Watson on the same page, right? Flying them out to L.A. And also they're meeting every day during this period of the offseason program. Thirdly, the fact is Dorsey is rewriting some pages in the playbook, bringing things that, you know, he thinks suits Deshaun better than already exists. For that reason, I think play calling is important. The play caller, let's say. I'm sure they're all going to be in agreement on the plays that will be called. Yeah. But the caller has the rhythm with the quarterback, you know?
Yeah.
And I think the rhythm is going a faster pace when Deshaun gets out there in this offense. And for that reason, I don't think Kevin has as much experience with that kind of quarterback that Dorsey does. So that's why I still think it's going to be Dorsey.
That's a very in-depth answer, Tony. And the first time I've heard it like that, and it makes a lot of sense when you explain it like that, of the rhythm of a quicker offense.
Yeah. Listen, Stefanski was great calling that play action passing game with Flacco. That's in his wheelhouse. That's kind of what he's used to. You know, he's never had a quarterback like Deshaun likes the freedom, you know, to go out of structure and make plays. And Dorsey has that experience. So that's why I think it's going that way.
Fact or fiction, Tony? This will be Amari Cooper's last year with the Cleveland Browns.
Well, I hope it's fiction. I'm going to say it's fiction. I still contend that there's a short-term extension coming for Cooper. This is his last year, carrying a cap number second highest on the team of like $23 million. Mm-hmm. You know, a two-year extension can reduce that significantly. And I do think that the trade for Jerry Jeudy makes makes Cooper a little more valuable, although they've denied it when I've asked that question. But having a guy that Judy looks up to so much, like Cooper, they got to do some coaching up of Jerry Judy to get what they want out of him. And I think Cooper's involved in that.
Last Browns one, very similar. Fact or fiction, this will be Elijah Moore's last season with the Cleveland Browns.
Ah, that's a tough one. Okay, he's still on his rookie contract. It's the last year of his rookie contract.
Yeah.
Ideally, you would extend him at some point this year. But I think they need to see what he looks like in this new offense and in the, you know, now in a new configuration with Jerry Judy and Cooper. So, but this could go either way, Zach.
Yeah.
And I'm going to say it's back. It will be his last year.
If I asked you this question on Saturday morning after the Browns took a wide receiver at 54, would that change your answer?
Oh, sure. Yeah.
Okay.
No, it wouldn't change my answer. It would be fact again.
Really?
Your question was fact for fiction. This is his last year.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Yeah. So you're saying it's his last year. Yes. Okay. Yeah.
So if they if they pick a receiver at 54, it reinforces my opinion that it will be his last year.
Got you. Yes. No, 100%. Yes. All right, Tony, let's do some NFL draft ones. Just general. Wait, okay. Mock 2.0 coming Thursday morning?
Yes, if not sooner, but probably Thursday morning.
The masses are ready, Tony. We can't wait. Fact or fiction, the first four picks of the NFL draft will all be quarterbacks. Would be the first time ever.
Yeah, I'm leaning towards fiction on that.
Really?
I am. And, you know, there's more talk recently of New England bypassing a quarterback, but keeping the pick, believe it or not, and taking Marvin Harrison. Mm-hmm. So if they go four quarterbacks in a row, the fourth would be J.J. McCarthy. Mm-hmm. And that's probably the odds-on favorite that they would be four quarterbacks. That New England takes Drake May, and then Minnesota trades up to four with what? Arizona has four, yep. I believe.
Yep.
I'm going to say fiction, though. I don't think we'll see history made on Thursday night.
Okay. Fact or fiction, Marvin Harrison Jr. is a better wide receiver prospect than Ja'Marr Chase coming out.
Wow. Oh, boy. That's a tough one.
Both very good.
Yeah, I think Chase might be a little more explosive.
Okay. Right? Yeah.
Explosive big plays were not that Harrison wasn't at Ohio State. Boy, that's a tough one. I think it depends on the quarterback that he ends up being connected with. And it's Chase couldn't have written a better script to you know, pair up with Burrow, his former teammate. I don't think there's who's the Ohio State quarterback that's waiting.
Kyle McCord was his. He's at Syracuse now, I think.
Yeah, since he's not eligible in this draft, I'll say it's not fact that he's going to be as good as Chase.
Okay. Yeah, to me, it's very interesting. It's like if Arizona does move out, like they're giving up almost a generational wide receiver prospect, to be honest, you know? And then
it depends how far they go down, you know? I mean, if they still think they have a chance to pick wide receiver two or wide receiver three, there's not a lot of difference. The rankings of those three receivers.
And I know Harbaugh keeps talking about offensive line and building the trenches, but he saw Marvin Harrison Jr. close up quite often, Tony. And that wide receiver room in Los Angeles for the Chargers isn't great.
Yeah, and he's at number five, waiting in the weed. I think he's going to move down, but you're right. The more I go over this first round, it seems predictable, but I don't think it's going to be easily predicted.
I thought that too, Tony. And then you know what makes it not predictable, I think? Everything coming out of Washington is it seems very non-predictable. And I feel like we could see a swerve there almost immediately, you know?
Well, any change in the predictions is going to change the whole flow of the round. So that's why any one of those teams can do something no one's expecting.
Fact or fiction, Tony, both the Steelers and Bengals draft a wide receiver in the first two rounds with one of their first two picks.
I think that's fact.
Okay.
Pittsburgh might go O-line receiver. I think Cincinnati could go receiver O-line. So I would say that's fact.
And what do you think that that would mean for the Browns in the division, especially since they could get a blue chip receiver there, Tony.
And a good enough lineman to really feel good about, you know. So that's why when we've done so much talk and analysis about where these teams stand right now, you know, they're getting a big input in the draft, Baltimore, Cincinnati and Pittsburgh. And Cincinnati, for sure, because they're loaded with offensive talent to begin with. Even though they lost Tyler Boyd, they're still going to play T. Higgins and his, you know, franchise tag him, I think. And then if you add a receiver to him, you know, he's easily replaced next year.
100%. This is kind of we're bending the rules of fact or fiction, but fact or fiction, you take the Ravens win the division or the field. I know that's not really a fact or fiction question, but would you rather pick the Ravens or one of the other three teams in the division?
I would take the field.
Okay. Why is that, Tony? You just think the it's just so unpredictable year to year.
Yeah. I think Baltimore's got a lot of recovering to do from offseason losses. They're good at it, but there's a lot there they have to recover. Three offensive line starters, you know, a lot of defensive changes, defensive coaches. Plus, you know me, I think Cincinnati is a very underrated team. And if Burrow stays healthy, I think they're right there with the Ravens. And so I'd take the field.
Take the field there. Tony, this is kind of a Browns one, but in general, fact or fiction, a Browns game this season will be decided by the new kickoff rule, meaning the new kickoff somehow will be the deciding touchdown or turnover, something like that.
Yeah, or a big game to set up a short field for the offense. Yeah, why not? I'll say fact. I hope that does happen. I think I said on RBS this morning, I think this rule change is one of the best rule changes in the NFL since the advent of instant replay. Really? I it's going to be fun to watch it develop and fun to see more returns for sure.
Yeah, and it's been interesting to see all the coaches talk, Tony. And I think Belichick brought it up on McAfee. You're going to see less corners and wide receivers on special teams and more linebackers and more linemen
big bodies, yeah.
So, I mean, that's going to be interesting. I mean, Andrew talked about it, I believe, in his presser about that determines the bottom of the roster a little bit.
Yeah, you know, we're focused on the actual returner, but there are all facets of this play that are changing as a result of this change, and that's one of them. The structure of your blockers, and we're talking about last spots on the roster, but I'm sure if it comes down to a cornerback or a linebacker, you know, that might weigh the deciding factor. We'll choose the linebacker because we need them more on the kickoff return.
It's going to be fascinating, Tony. Say the Browns have a kickoff and it's under 2 minutes to go. Like, do you put Batonio out there and you have him pulling?
I wouldn't go that far.
Well, the strategy, and you never know what, you know, I'm thinking of the strategy of it. Nobody knows. That's what's exciting about it. You know,
the other thing is, I know Kevin has pretty much stated they intend to, I don't know if it's the rule or that you have to have two returners, you know, split returners.
Yeah. Yeah.
But that's in itself is different, you know, and that opens up to new creativity in the return game. You know, the cross field lateral could come back. One of the best plays. I remember the Browns pulling off against the Saints to win a game when the Saints were defending champions under Mangini. So anything can happen.
There we go. Fact or fiction, Bill Belichick will be coaching in the NFL next season.
You know, I think he's going to be an unbelievable hit in media.
Yes, he is.
I mean, big time. I've seen that side of Belichick, the real interesting and open and just educational Belichick. I've seen that in him in past Super Bowls when the Patriots were first making their dynasty run. So I think he's going to be such a hit. He's going to grow to like it. And I think, fact, he's not going to be coaching next year because of it.
So you think the media love he'll get will outweigh that itch of the coach?
I think so. Plus, I think there's still enough teams hesitant, you know, of hiring a 72-year-old coach who demands pretty much total control.
Yeah, definitely. All right, last one, Tony. The biggest question, this is what Browns fans are wondering. Fact or fiction, the Browns will make a selection at pick 54.
I'm going to say fact.
Really?
I think he stays pat there. And the reason I say that is I think there's going to be a player that is rated high enough on their board not to pass up at the expense of getting a fourth round pick in return. So I'm going to say fact.
One more bonus then. Fact or fiction, Andrew Berry makes a trade somewhere during the draft.
No doubt. Lock it in. Facts. Hopefully he'll trade both seventh round picks and get the heck out of that last round.
So you can end your day on Saturday a little early, Tony?
An hour earlier. Exactly.
I love that, Tony. It's going to be a very interesting week. As you said, you know, NFL draft week, it's been such a long process, but we're coming down to it now, and there's going to be, I think, a lot of surprises. And it's going to be very interesting to watch what the division does, because exactly, they're all picking right near each other. I think it goes Bengals, Steelers, and then Ravens not too far after that. So they're all going to be, you know, right in that group where we see them adding players.
Plus, we'll be bystanders on Thursday night when they're adding first round picks. So
yes, definitely.
Could be a tough weekend for the Browns, but we'll see.
We'll see. All right, Tony, you have a great weekend. Great week this week. I know it felt good to be back in Berea around the guys.
Yep. Very good. It's football season has begun.
Yes, it has. All right. Have a good weekend, Tony.
All right. Thanks, Zach. See you then.